Dizziness due to vestibular hypofunction secondary to labyrinthitis, vestibular neuritis, Meniere's disease, or some other condition can often lead to chronic dizziness. Such dizziness may persist even if the underlying disease state has resolved, leading to a baseline sense of imbalance. For such patients, the goal is to help the brain recalibrate, taking into account the vestibular hypofunction and reset the overall balance system to the new settings, so to speak. The main way to accomplish this are gaze stability exercises. Initially, these exercises should all be performed while sitting still. Keep in mind when performing these exercises that the goal is to try to move your head as fast as possible without your vision blurring. The goal is 120 to 240 head shakes per minute. If you start to get visual blurring, slow the head movements down. But the goal is to always go as fast as possible, right up to the limit when visual blurring occurs. So our first exercise is a vestibular ocular reflex times one, otherwise known as VOR times one. And remember, we're going to start this by doing it seated. You're going to take a pen and hold it right here in front of you, semi-close, and you're going to take your head and start moving it side to side, keeping your gaze on the pen. Remember, the goal is to go as fast as you can without blurring your vision. So we're going to go ahead and increase the speed side to side, keeping our gaze on that pen. The goal is to get to 120 to 240 per minute, and then we can go ahead and take this up and down as well. So starting off slow, just seeing where your speed is at, and then gently moving in a faster motion, just nice and gentle, small movements, keeping that gaze and tempo steady. Our next exercise is going to be the VOR Far, and this is where you look at something in a distance, pick a letter or an object that's on the other wall, and give it a gaze and start to turn your head side to side. Just like we did with the VOR times one, but with this object at a distance. So it's not much of a turn, just maintain that speed without blurring the vision. And we're going to do the same thing as well with the up, down, up, down. For the VOR times two, we're going to bring back our pen, and this time our pen is going to go in one direction and our head's going to go in the other, but we're going to keep focus on the pen. So other, other. So we're going the exact opposite direction. It's not a big movement. Just take the time to practice this side to side and then see if you can't go faster and smoother, again without blurring the vision. We're going to do the gaze stability reading. You're going to take a sheet of your printed letters and hold this out about arm distance. You're going to then begin to turn your head side to side, gazing at the letters and maintaining that same even tempo without blurring the vision. Then begin to read the letters D, E, Z, A, S, E, L, T, H, O. Make sure to read the letters all the way through until you're done with that one page. Our next exercise is imaginary VOR. So we're going to take our pen back in front of us, and you're going to close your eyes and turn your head, imagining that your eye is still focused on the target. So your eye is still moving as if it's focused on the pen, but with your eyes closed. So you're going to start center, close, turn, open, close, turn, open, close, turn, open. Feel free to vary your speed and also vary how much you turn your head. Trying to maintain the eye on the target every time you turn and close your eyes. Our last exercise is the two target head turns. We're going to take two pens this time. And what we're going to start with first is we're going to shift our gaze with our eyes towards one pen. Right now I'm looking at the red. Then I'm going to turn my head following that gaze. Next, I'm going to shift my eyes to the other target and then turn my head following that gaze. So eyes first, head, eyes, head, eyes, head. Again, playing with the speed and the distance of which you turn your head You can also do this up and down, so shifting your eyes from the center up, then the gaze, down, gaze, up, gaze, down, gaze. It takes a moment to get the tempo of the eyes going first and then following with the head, but just practice it and play with tempo and speed. As your balance improves, one should add standing and walking while doing these same exercises. It is recommended that you get 20 minutes of walking starting slow and working up to your normal pace of walking while adding the hand and eye motions already described. The second recommendation for treating a vestibular hypofunction are balance exercises, whether static or dynamic. You can start with heel to toe standing in the corner or opening up those feet a little bit. Once able to, try standing on one leg for at least 30 seconds. Finally, advance to slow marches of heel to toe walking or even lunges. The third recommendation are habituation exercises. These involve doing an exercise protocol of repeated exposures to a stimulus that bothers you until the brain tamps down on its abnormal response and no longer causes dizziness. A common habituation exercise could be repeated rolling over in bed, doing 180-degree turns, bending forward and back up again, etc. Keep in mind that these are basic strategies to help with dizziness due to vestibular hypofunction. Better and faster results can potentially be obtained by working with a qualified vestibular physical therapist who can come up with a custom exercise program that is specific for you. Good luck.